What's up, guys? Just got back from work and I found me this little quizzy whizzy. Let's have a go. How well do you know Final Fantasy? Well, I like to think I know a thing or two. And then I do these fucking quizzes and I get like 2 of 10 and I get demoralized as fuck because I think the only good thing I do is Final Fantasy and I can't even do that right. But fuck it, let's give it a go. In Final Fantasy VII, Sabin was... Well, we've already kicked off to a stellar start there. In Final Fantasy VII, Sabin from Final Fantasy VI was originally supposed to have facial hair, but it was removed from the final version. That had better be false, just because it's an absolute poorly worded bugger of a question. Well, it could be, they could have done it on purpose. It could be a trick question, but let's go false. False. Trick question. Clever. In Final Fantasy Tactics, Moogles are extinct. That is true. True. True diddy true.
True.
Square Enix is not developing a Final Fantasy title for just the PS4. Bit of a tricky worded question that one, or I'm just a dumb motherfucker. Square Enix is not developing. I get you. Final Fantasy 15 and the 7 remake. That's about it, right? That's about it, and neither of those are coming to X-Bone or the PC Master Race, so that is... That's a false. That's a false. Click. Click, damn you. Yes! Held it. Off to a stellar start. The main character in Final Fantasy VI was supposed to be a female character in his 20s, but the older? The main character in Final Fantasy VI was supposed to be a female character in his 20s. What a stupid motherfucker. I don't know if they're doing this on purpose, trying to piss us off, but the idea was scrapped and Terra came to be. Well, once again, either this person who made this quiz is dumb as fuck, or they're just trying to trick us. Right, let's go false. Trick question. Another trick question. Yep, another trick question. All poorly worded, one or the other. Dumb motherfucker or trick question. Final Fantasy got its name from the fact it was supposed to be Square Enix's last ever game. This little doozy. Now, I actually know the answer to this. But I know not about 95% of people don't. And it's like the biggest misconception. And I bet if I click... Fucking knew it! Fucking knew it! Fucking called it! Let's clear this one up, because you're wrong, Mr. Quizmaster! You're wrong! Final Fantasy was not called Final Fantasy because it was going to be Square Enix's final game. That is wrong! They came out and cleared it up. It was called Final Fantasy. History lesson, it was originally going to be called Fighting Fantasy. But then another game, or clone, or I don't know what it was. Something else had the title Final Fantasy. Fighting Fantasy. So they had to change it, but they liked the fantasy. You know, they liked fantasy and they wanted to keep that. They liked the way it rolled off the tongue. So they pretty much went through a list of F words that would fit in and Final Fantasy stuck. It's literally as underwhelming as that. Wrong, Mr. Quizmaster. In Final Fantasy VII, a portrait of Hironobu Sakaguchi appears on the wall outside one of the houses in Rocket Town. Not being funny here, guys, but if I'd have seen a picture of just a little Japanese man on the wall in Final Fantasy VII, I think I would have noticed it. I think I would have noticed if my boy the Gucci's face was on a wall. I'm gonna go... False. False indeed. Final Fantasy creators have a tendency to name their characters after meteorological effects. Well, I'm guessing they're going on cloud and squall on that one. Does that count as meteorological effects? Even if it does, I wouldn't say that's a tendency. Let's go false on that one. False. Final Fantasy IX is the only Final Fantasy game to have a separate water element but no water summon. Final Fantasy IX had Leviathan. I'm pretty sure of that one. False. And there's been a lot of falses in this. Let's have some truths. I suppose just making up a load of bullshit and not asking us to click false. Let's have some truths. Final Fantasy Summon of Ice Shiva is actually a Hindu god that reigns over fire and destruction. True or false? Now that's something I can imagine to be true. That kind of backwards logic, like a quirky little fact. That's something I can imagine to be true. And we've had a lot of falses so far, so that premise alone. On this one, I'm going to go true. True! Yes, at last we have a true. And we learn something new with a true. Although, probably going to Google that now, because this Quizmaster's credibility has already been blown to fuck. So I ain't going to believe it off of that. Final Fantasy is not about classical literature or world culture, it's about the fantasy. A stupid question. Or at least it sounds stupid to me. Is it about classical literature and world culture? It's about fantasy. Well, there's definitely culture. Final Fantasy? 12 is definitely culture. Yeah, 12 is definitely culture. This has got to be another false. Surely. Another false. Cloud's Buster Sword was not originally coded into Final Fantasy X, and because of this was taken out before the game released. I actually only learned about this a couple of weeks ago. Apparently it was coded into the game and then taken out before release. So Cloud's Buster Sword was not. And they're fucking sneaky with this quiz. They slip in little double negatives. They slip in little sneaky knots. And I think they're doing it just to make it they seem to like their falses. Even the true ones, they slip in a knot, so it's a false. Fucking hell. Final Fantasy X is the only Final Fantasy where you're forced to obtain Shiva after Ifrit. I'm gonna go thinking through every Final Fantasy, but in 8 that's definitely true. You definitely have to go get Ifrit first. You go to that cave with Quistis. That's like your first mission. 7. When did you get him in 7? No, you get Shiva from Priscilla in the Junon town, you know, the ship one with all the fish bones. And you get Ifrit on the ship. You get Ifrit on the ship, you're travelling over, and you kill Genova, so that's false. Wait, are there any knots in there? Final Fantasy, only Final Fantasy where you're forced. False. Fucking liar! Although, they did say forced, and Shiva in 7, I might be wrong on this one. I think Shiva in 7 was optional. But it's still, but man, they slip in sneaky wordings. Forced! Sneaky. In the US version of Final Fantasy X, Yuna tells Tidus she needs him at the end. In the Japanese version, she simply thanks him. Well, that's a bloody stupid question. I mean, she doesn't. She doesn't say, Yuna doesn't say she needs him at the end. In the West of, I mean, I don't know what version you guys are playing in America, but in the version I played, you know, she doesn't fall through Tidus and say, "I need you." that would just be fucking weird. She says, "I love you." So, on that alone, I'm gonna go false. False, man. This quiz is bullshit. It cost 58 million to craft Final Fantasy XII, whereas the next entry to the series, Final Fantasy XIII, is rumoured to have been graced with a budget increase by at least 70%. True or false? Now, I'm a bit of a loser, and I know how much 13 cost. It cost 65 million US dollars. Baller expensive. Most expensive Final Fantasy game we've ever had, I believe. Pretty sure on that. Even more expensive than what 7 was. So 65 is obviously not 70% above 58 million, and I highly doubt that 13 was that under budget. So let's go false. False! I'm fucking nailing this quiz! Final Fantasy IX is the first Final Fantasy where the main character is no longer around at the end. But Zidane is around. Zidane is around at the end. I mean, yeah, sure, he sods off for a bit, like a year or something, but he comes back. So Final Fantasy IX is the first. It's no longer around, but he's Vivi. Vivi. I nearly forgot about Vivi. Of course, Vivi dies.
Spoiler alert, by the way, in case you didn't know. Shit.
But no, that's not the first. That's not the first. In 5, we had a loss, beginning in G and ending in Aloof. And we had Shadow in 6. It was optional on whether he died or not. Don't know if that counts, but let's go false. Of course it's false. Of course it's false. Man, this next one, I might as well just close my eyes and answer false. Final Fantasy IX Strategy Guide was voted the most useful strategy guide ever made. Might as well pick false, because why not? Why not? Yep, false. Final Fantasy IX Strategy Guide was absolute shit. Pile of shit, bin it. There is someone named Cid in every Final Fantasy game. And now this is another little tricky-wicky one. This is another little sneaky. I know that in 1 and 2, and I think maybe 3. Well, I think maybe Final Fantasy 3 is where it started, but definitely 1 and 2, there weren't Cids. Originally, there weren't Cids, and they went back at a later date and coded either characters in, new characters, or they just changed the names. But I know they coded in Cids, so there was someone named Cid in every Final Fantasy game, not originally, but as there is now. I mean, this is a swing question. This person could put this either way. Let's go true. True! True! I don't know why I'm so excited. This is literally like the worst quiz ever. I'm sorry, I should have proofread this one first, although that kind of defeats the objective of a quiz. Final Fantasy VII was originally designed for the Nintendo 64. True or false? Can easily believe this one to be true. What I do know about 7 is it got infinitely bigger throughout its development cycle. You know, it started off at X size and it just got bigger and bigger and bigger as it went on. Characters like Zack, I know he was introduced, he was sort of, the idea of him was only conceived about halfway through development, and then they went back and added things in, added a new plot. I kind of think it was the same with Vincent, not too sure on that one, but definitely with Zack. And just things with the FMVs, yeah, I can believe it was originally going to be from Nintendo 64. True! Man, I think, I'm not keeping track of my score, but I actually think I'm doing pretty sick. I think this might be the best I've ever done, which is kind of sad considering this is the worst quiz ever. Final Fantasy VII was the first Final Fantasy to feature character switching in battle. Man, can you take your squeaky toy somewhere else? I am trying to do a Final Fantasy quiz here. Are you for real, mate? Get out of it! Yeah. Didn't have character switching, but it should have done. It should have done. That's my one gripe with 7, 8, and 9. Come here!
Mate, are you taking the piss? Come say hello to everyone. We're doing a quiz, calm down. Right.
So yeah, didn't have character switching. Let's go false on that one. False! Blitzball from Final Fantasy X was voted as one of the top fictional sports games. True or false? Again, voted by who? Voted by Final Fantasy fans? I mean, if they're talking about voted by Final Fantasy fans, without a doubt. But there's quite an important detail. Voted by this fucking bullshit quiz maker. I guess someone there has voted it the top fictional sport game, so true. Right, let's see what my final score is on this utter bullshit quiz. Pile of crap quiz. I got 18 out of 20 right. I am an expert on Final Fantasy facts. Mate, this quiz was sick. This quiz was great. Top quality quiz.